Okay, so we're going to talk about Zarabanda's training so that we can stay consistent at home. So here we built the foundation of all of these commands, but it's important to practice them and practice them in different environments. That way he understands to listen to the rules at home with you in many situations. So like going to the store or going to the park and continuing to work on Zarabanda's socialization skills. Because of his breed, it's very important that we get him exposed to a lot of different distractions, dogs, people, all of that, different types of flooring. That way he is confident and not leaning on trying to be reactive or scary in cases where he might feel a little insecure. So we definitely want to stress that. But let's talk about his commands on how we can take him out in public and have a nice, well-behaved, polite dog. So we're going to start with heel. Heel means walk next to me on a loose leash on the left-hand side. So that means the leash will have slack in it. There's not going to be like tightness on the leash. And we're going to follow through with using these tools in case he's pushing the boundaries, because dogs don't transfer respect from person to person automatically. So we have to show him that we understand the rules, we understand the training, and we're going to follow through with our commands. So heel means walk next to me on the left-hand side. And of course, we want to reward this command when he's out and about. That way he gets a positive association with doing the training with you. It takes about 2 weeks for dogs to understand that the boundary kind of transfers over. So keep that in mind. It does take 2 weeks of practice and really following the boundaries and the rules before he's kind of like, got it. Okay, I have to listen here too, not just at the training facility. So we have heel, then we have sit. So sit means stay until he's told free. So if you're on your walk and you have to stop, like at a road or something, have him sit. Whenever you stop, if you need to tie your shoe or anything like that, have him sit. He should do it for the most part automatically, but he might need a reminder here and there, especially if there are distractions around, because he's going to be focused on something else. We'll verbally remind him sit. And then if that doesn't work, we have these tools to kind of get him paying attention to us again. So then we have free. Free means he's released from a command. So with heel or sit, if it's time for him to like go sniff or go to the bathroom or anything, you would tell him free and then walk him to the grassy area where he can go to the bathroom. So free is the release from the command. And that brings us to place. So place is a boundary stay on a bed. So when guests come over, instead of just having him like loose and doing whatever, we would put him on place. That way your guests can come in and maybe even give him some treats so that he's not intimidated or feels the need to react when they're over. And that way he has a positive association with people coming to the house that are welcome. And again, working on that socialization, making sure he has that positive association with people coming over. So we put him on place, which is a boundary stay. The rules of place are you just have to stay on this bed, no barking, no chewing on the bed, and no getting off until you're told free. But with that, we don't free from a distance. We always go back to Zarabanda, tell him good place. We pay him for doing a good job, because training is like work. He's going to get paid for the work that he does. So good place, reward, free. Then we free him when we're like just a foot away from him. That way this stays really strong, because if we always free him from the other side of the room, he's just going to assume once you're at the other side of the room to just jump off. So we don't want him to assume that. We want him to think he's a mime in a box and has to wait for us to come open the door and tell him free. So then we have down. Down is what you're going to use when you don't have a place bed. So like when you're out in public, let's say you're at the checkout at like Lowe's or something, put him into a down. That way you can check out, handle everything, and then tell him free or heel to walk with you outside of the store. Down means lay down and stay. So it's not get off from jumping. It's lay down and stay. And then again, we don't free from a distance. We always go back to him, good down, and then release free. So you can work on that when you're out in public and you don't have like the place bed. And you can also do it at home, of course. And then we have come when called. So everything should be done on leash first. You should practice all the commands indoors and outdoors on a leash to make sure that you can guide him if he gets a little confused, because again, respect doesn't transfer automatically. So he'll need some reminders that you know the commands. So come when called, you should have a 30 to 50 foot long leash when you're out, especially if there's no leash. That way, if he gets distracted and doesn't listen to the remote, you can still get him back to you. It's just come as he runs to you, good boy, praise, have him sit, then give him the reward, and then you can either tell him free, he can go explore again, or you can tell him heel, and then you can go on about your business. So definitely the more you practice the commands, the better he's going to be at them. It's kind of like practicing a skill. If you do a little bit every day, you're going to be sharp at that skill, but if you only do it once a month, you're going to be a little bit rusty. So make sure to practice with him and stay consistent. Then we have leave it. If you drop something on the ground, tell him leave it. He's not allowed to go get it. And then that brings us how to correct if he doesn't listen to the commands. So we have his remote collar here, and I'm going to show you how to turn it on. The collar itself has a little red dot right here, and the remote has a matching red dot on the side. It's just a little dot. It's not a big button or anything. They are magnetic keys to turn on the collar. So we're going to turn it on real quick. You're going to see a green light flash. That means the collar's on, charged, and ready to go. It'll flash green every few seconds to let you know that it's on and charged. If you start seeing orange or red, that means the collar's running low on battery and it's about to die. Then to turn on the remote, the back button back here, we're going to push and hold it until the screen lights up. And he is at level 30. Again, it's this back button right here. Just push and hold it until the screen lights up and you'll see a level 30. So we're going to pretend my hand is Zarabanda real quick. And so we're working with Zarabanda. He's doing a good job, but let's say you stop on a walk and you ask him to sit and he doesn't. We are going to mark that incorrect behavior with a no first. So you're always going to say no, follow through with the black S button, and then repeat the command sit. So that makes my hand twitch a little bit. What this is an electric muscle stimulator. So it actually contracts the muscle a little bit so that it gives a correction that he understands, and it can lead to off-leash training because we can communicate with him from a distance and we don't need the leash on. So any behavior that he does that's incorrect, it's no, black S button, repeat the command. And again, it makes my thumb twitch just a little bit. I don't like the feeling, but it's just enough to get him to stop the unwanted behavior. We're not trying to scare him or anything. We just want him to understand that there are consequences for your actions. If you do the behavior correctly, you're going to get treats and rewards. If you don't, there's a little consequence to make sure we follow through with those commands and that they aren't just, we aren't just bribing him with treats. He does have rules to follow now. So anything and everything, use this. You don't ever want to use this as a threat. This is just the consequence that happens for his actions. If you start using it as a threat, he becomes collar savvy and he will only listen with this collar on. And we're going to talk more about the other details of the collar at the end of the video, but that's pretty much it. It's this black S button over here. That's what we're going to use. Then we have his prong collar. So like I said, he should be on a leash indoors and outdoors until we kind of get the routine of all of his training. So how to put this on is we unhook it like this. My finger's stuck. And then we're going to pinch these together to put it back. So it's a little bit difficult. You're going to push down at an angle and pop the collar up at the angle of the prong. Then you have to squeeze this together to put it back. You can't pull it down, it's not gonna work. You have to squeeze and make sure they go in like this. And that way all the prongs look like this so that you know it's set and correct. Again, this is just to help guide him with the leash on. So to kind of recap everything, heel, loose leash walking, sit stay, stay is implied, down stay, play stay. The stay is implied, you don't have to say it, and it's stay until you're told free. We don't free from a distance. Then we have come when called, come, run to me, sit, get your treat. Again, as he comes to you, we back up and praise to let him know that he's doing the correct behavior. We're kind of rewarding in the moment. And then when he finally gets to us, then he gets his physical treat, his payday. And then we have leave it, don't get that off of the ground. So the important things are have fun with Zarabanda. Make sure you're having a good time and you bring plenty of treats in the beginning. That way you can reward that behavior. Stay consistent. That's going to be the biggest thing to make sure you're set up for success. Once you have your boundaries laid out, stay consistent with them and what you're asking. And then just, you know, have fun with him. Practice daily. The more you practice, the better results you'll get from the training program. So now we're going to show you Zarabanda's commands.
Brian's son is that way too. Oh, yeah. He's afraid of my cat.
Yeah.
Down. Good boy. Good down. 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 Good down. Down. Free. Good job. Good boy. Place. Good boy. Place. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the other features of the remote collar. So like in the beginning, I showed you how to turn the collar on. Now we're going to turn the collar off. So the two red magnets again, we're going to touch together, turns the remote collar off. This collar should last about 2 days on a charge as long as you're turning it off at night. Zarabanda can wear it 10 to 12 hours a day, take it off at night. So we're going to turn it back on so you can see all the features. And then to turn this off, it's just the on-off button in the back. We're going to push and hold it until the screen is dark. Once the screen's dark, it's off, and then we're going to turn it back on. Okay, so we went over the black S button is the correction, right? You just tap it, but even if you hold the button, it's just that quick little stimulation. The red S button is for emergencies only. It's going to boost the level up plus 30, I believe. Yeah, so it's going to be 60. We have not needed this for Zarabanda. This is just in case you're practicing and he gets away from you and he's heading towards something dangerous like the road or anything, and you call him back and he's like super distracted by something and he's not listening. This is an elevated level to kind of snap him back to reality, and you only use it if and when needed. You might never need that level. So it's just the red for emergencies only. Don't push it unless you absolutely need it. And then we have vibrate over here, this T button. You don't want to use this too much because it's not super, it's like counting to three. It's not really a consequence. It's just kind of a warning. Maybe down the road when he's doing a pretty good job and you want to just say, hey, you know, straighten up a little bit, then that would be the time and place to use the vibrate, but I would not use it anytime soon. So then we have the M/C button, which is momentary or continuous. So on the screen, you see just the letter M. That stands for momentary. So that means when you push and hold the buttons, you see the red light flashes just once when you push it. If you were to change it to the C setting, it would continuously stimulate until you let go. And Zarabanda does not need that where he's at with training. We use that in the beginning on lower levels to introduce the collar in a fun way with lots of treats. So next we have the on-off button in the back, which is also, instead of pushing and holding it to turn the remote off, if you just tap it again, Zarabanda becomes a flashlight. So you can see him at night. Tap it again. So when you're putting the collar on, we have this bungee, right? Makes it super easy to put on and take off. You want to make sure the light's facing out and that it's nice and high on his neck. That way he can feel it, and it does need to fit snug so that the connections can make, or the little prongs here can make good connection to his skin so that he can actually feel the collar. If it's too loose, it's not going to be effective. So we want to make sure it's snug. But keeping that in mind, with him drinking and if he drools and moisture gets in between the collar and his skin, that can build up a bacteria which could lead to a skin infection. So you want to make sure that you keep the skin right here really dry when you're putting it on. And then of course you can wear it all day, every single day. Make sure you are consistent with this so he doesn't become collar savvy and only listens with the collar on. We want to make sure he listens all the time. So make sure to prevent that from happening so he doesn't get a little hot spot here. And then of course it's snug, allowing only 1 to 2 fingers in between. But we do have this bungee that stretches, so it's not going to be too tight on him, but it will fit very snug. And how it should fit on his neck is the remote collar goes up as high as you can, and then the prong collar kind of varies. You either put it above it, but if the prong collar is slightly too big because he's growing, sometimes we need to add links, and then it's a little awkward because it's a little too big, but if we took a link out, it's a little too small. So if it's a little bit big, it goes below, but if it's just right, it goes above. And you just kind of have to play that by ear as he's growing, you know, because he's still a puppy, so he's going to grow more. And then we have the charging port on the back. So these are rechargeable. Again, should last about 2 days on a charge. Make sure that's closed because these are both waterproof, so he can go swimming with them, all that fun stuff. Charging port is underneath here by the prongs. Again, close that, keep the dirt and debris out to keep it running smooth. I'm gonna turn this off. Oh, wait, one more thing. So 30 works right now, but that level might need to change as he goes home. If he's less distracted at home, we can turn the level down if it's being effective. Again, it just needs to be strong enough to stop the unwanted behavior. So if you notice that 30 is not enough or too much, you can change that. So how to change it? You first have to hold the dial down, and then the 1D is going to start flashing. That means you can now change the level to lower it or make it more. You can adjust it now just by twisting it. So once you have it on the level you want it at, you then push down and hold again. The 1D is solid, it is locked into place, and you can't adjust it because it's locked. So that 1D, once it's solid, it's locked into place. So that's how you change it up, down when needed. We're gonna turn this off. Oh, yeah, red light turned off. Push and hold the on off button in the back right here. You have to hold it for a little bit. That's why you have to hold it, or else you'll turn on the flashlight. So that's the remote collar. And of course we went over the prong collar already. In here, we have the strap that it came with, which is just a belt buckle style, which sometimes can be difficult because you might not get it on the exact right one each time. So that's why the bungee strap's super easy. Then we have the charger, so we can charge both the collar and the remote at the same time. It usually only takes a few hours to charge, so you do not have to leave it on the charger overnight. When you take this off at night, again, wear it all day, 10 to 12 hours a day, take it off at night, then charge it if needed. So every couple of days or so, I would put it on the charger, but don't leave it on the charger overnight, or else it'll like eat up the battery and then it won't last as long. And then we have these long prongs, which he doesn't have long hair, but he does have a lot of skin. So I didn't think he needed these, but you have them in case you want them. And then this is the little tool to change the prongs on the collar itself. This little tool right there. And then we have the instruction manual, so that you can go over all the buttons in greater detail. And that is it on the remote collar information and the prong collar. Basically, we want to reward the behaviors we like to increase the rate of those behaviors. So make sure you bring treats, praise, petting, rewards are for doing a good job. And then we use this to stay consistent, to correct the unwanted behaviors, to decrease the rate of those behaviors. And that's where we get that balance of, you're going to do it to get treats, but you're also going to do it to avoid corrections, to make sure, you know, that's why we drive the speed limit, to avoid getting a ticket and to get to our destination safely. So that's it. Again, have fun and stay consistent, and you will be great with Zara on your new adventure of obedience.